Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. First of all, thank you for the opportunity. And my name is Farahia Akmal binti Manawi. And my co-author is Prof. Dr. Abdul Malik Itambi. So for today, I'm going to present a paper titled The Practical of an Exploratory Factor Analysis with the Evidence Gathered from a Study titled The Integrations of Technological Support on Risk Management. So for the introduction, the EFA itself, basically, it is a statistical method used to examine the covariance relationship among many observed items to the reflectance factor to account for the relationship. The applications of EFA will help the researcher in order to make a decision to retain or drop the questions from the questionnaire before they start to distribute the questionnaire to the respondents. So, as the practical of analysis, the study was conducted to 104 lecturers from UiTM Kelantan. A questionnaire consists of 20 questions with 7 skills was used to gather the data to identify the integrations of technological support in knowledge management activity in UiTM Cawangan Kelantan. And so generally, the knowledge management has become a vital part of the institution strategy to manage the tangible and the intangible information assets of the institution itself. With the integrations of technology support components, it will be able to increase the efficiency of knowledge management process in the institution. So from Palin 2013, she underlined 3 main steps involved in conducting the factor analysis. Step 1. So, it starts with the assessment of stability, suitability of data for factor analysis. Second, factor extraction. It involves 3 main things, which is the Kaiser criterion, screen test, and parallel analysis. And step 3 is factor rotation and the interpretations of data. So, the EFA itself is a statistical procedure used to reduce, as I mentioned before, it is a statistical procedure used to reduce a large numbers of observed variables to small numbers of research factors, or component among a group of observed variables. So the main purpose of adapting the EFA procedure is to examine the relationship among observed variables and a small numbers of underlying facts. So the KMO, Kaiser-Meyer-Olkind. So from research, Richard and Dean, 2007, said that the objective of this test is to measure the sampling adequacy in order to determine the factorability of metric or data set as a whole. Okay, while from Field 2000, explained that to justify the main purpose, the main objective of KMO is to justify the adequate sampling value of KMO, the value should be larger than 0.5. But from Pellant, said that the acceptable value for KMO is 0.6. While Kaiser 1974 indicate or recommend that a bare minimum of 0.5 with a value between 0.5 to 0.7 can be categorized as average, while the KMO value between 0.7 to 0.8 are good, okay, and value between 0.8 and 9 are great, while value 0 with 0.9 and above are superb. Okay. For Bartlett test of sparsity, the main objective of this test is to measure the multivariate normality of set distribution. This test also check the null hypothesis that its original correlation metric is an identified metric. So the significant value less than 0.05 indicates that these data do not produce an identity metric and are thus approximately multivariate normal and acceptable for further analysis. This is based on Palin 2013 and Field 2000. The next one is factor extraction. From Hardy et al. 2016 said that the factor rotation is one of the strategies of defining a small number of factors that can be used to best signify the whole of relationship between the research construct. Okay, the numbers of methods that might be used to help in making decision regarding determining the small numbers of factors that should be retained. The most frequently used method is known as eigenvalues or the Kaiser criteria. Under this criterion, components with eigenvalues larger than 1 are retained, a factor which explains total 70 to 80% of variance is retained for the next process of. Okay, so this is the summary of output from EFA. So number one, we have, we should check for the Kaiser, Mayer Olkin, the KMO, and Bartlett test of sparsity. So for the descriptions, the KMO value should be C 0.6 and above. The Bartlett test of sparsity should be less than 0.5. Okay, next, identify the numbers of factor or components in the total variance. So we can use the Kaiser criterion and eigenvalues for every component. Step 3, we are going to assess the scree plot. Identify the shape. What should we do? We should identify the shape of the plot. And parallel analysis, identify the numbers of factors should be retained or removed. Next, step 5, check on the components. Okay, the unrotated loading of items are shown. And step 6, analyze the pattern metric table. We should identify the numbers of factors analysis during the process. Okay, as for the practical analysis, we are going to use the data from this study. Next. So this is the demographic profile. So basically the study involved 104 respondents from UiTM Cawang Kelantan. So start with the reliability analysis of the questionnaire. For the knowledge management, the Cronbach alpha is 0.95, numbers of items is 8, the strength of association is excellent based on hair. Next, technological support, the Cronbach alpha is 0.939 and the strength of association indicate excellent. So we'll start with the KMO. From the analysis, it indicate that the KMO value for this study is 0.8 for knowledge management, and KMO value for technological support is 0.81. So it indicate that it exceed the recommended value minimum of 0.5 as stated by Kaiser 1970, which is the main required, the basic requirement for KMO is the value, the KMO value should be exceed or greater than 0.6. Okay. Next, Bartlett sparsity test. So the total variance explained for knowledge management. The percentage of variance for first component of knowledge management explained 33.39%, and the division values is equal to 5.99. For the second component, the percentage of variance is 30.51%, with initial eigenvalues is 0.56. And lastly, the third component shows that the percentage of variance is 23.7 of the variance and 0.4% for the eigenvalues. While the total variance explained for the third component for technological support, it shows that percentage of components is 39.20% with the eigenvalues is 5.24 for the second component for technological support equal to 1.185, and the percentage of variance is 26.6%. Finally, the last components for technological support explained 21.39% of variance and 0.56 of eigenvalues. Both of these analyses are significant with p equal to 0.00. Therefore, it is acceptable for further analysis as indicated by Palin and Field. For the components matrix, you can see that the component matrix for knowledge management was divided into three components. Okay, so components number one is can be categorized as dissemination. Components number two is application, and components number three is accusation based on the factor loading was generated. And this is the rotated component metric for technological support. Okay, it also can be categorized into three, was categorized to three components. So the components was categorized into three, which is number one is infrastructure, database, and PO. So as for the conclusion, I can say that exploratory factorisation has been applied as initial procedure which should be conducted by the researcher before they are conducting the further analysis. The result should be classified, clarified, and explained the research factor in conjunction to answer the research question and achieve the research objective. Okay, therefore, the 16 items was analyzing with the EFA procedure. As for the conclusion, all the EFA results achieve the minimum requirement of analysis. So, for any questions or inquiries, please do not hesitate to address the questions to my email, farahiakmal@uitm.edu.my or farahia_akmal@yahoo.com. So, till then, I end my presentation with thank you. Assalamualaikum.